Topic for today's discussion is about the importance of beneficial insects in agriculture. So, in this chapter, we are going to deal with what the importance of the insects is, as we have popular classification as the insects of economic importance, of no economic importance. Those with economic importance, they will have the matter that they will be either beneficial or productive. So then these insects are important. They are going to give you benefit in the sense what they are doing, their activity in that particular field or in that area, or they are providing you with some products that are utilized commercially throughout the trade and commerce, as well as day-to-day life of all the human beings on the earth. Then the next stage, what are these beneficial insects? Now, these beneficial insects are those insects which are carrying out some or the other kind of activity, and that does help the human beings get some benefit directly or indirectly, and they are going to provide the products during the activities of their life cycle. Now, this is popular classification that I have earlier told. The importance of beneficial insects in agriculture is either in two ways, that is of no economic importance and of economic importance. Now, this is economic importance, that is divided into useful insects as well as productive insects. Now, what are the insects uses in our day-to-day life? We can use those insects in biological research, as pollinators, as food, as consumers. They are acting there in the ecosystem or environment. Then soil builders, in forensic entomology, as bioindicators, or in aesthetics, philosophy, and culture. Now, the second thing, or second classification, is they are either productive insects, which are creating or which are having some synthesis of some products from their body while they are alive, or their whole body itself is utilized as a substance or as an any utility or proper product for the treatment or whatever it may be in the human lifestyle. So honeybee is producing the honey and beeswax. The silk is produced by silkworms. Different types of silkworms are there. Then the lac insect producing lac, different dyes and related substances which are extracted from those insects, their bodies. Then the next is regarding medicine, some products which are out of their body collected for a utilization in treatment. Then first point in useful insects, it's the biological research, wherein the genetic data or behavioral data or their activities, they are studied, and inferences are made out of that, and the people, they get the knowledge. The scientists, they fetch that knowledge and utilize that, disseminate that knowledge for knowing some new things in the whatever are going in the universe regarding the live species. Then some insects, they are utilized or they are acting as pollinators. These pollinators, they are doing this activity in unknowingly, means that is important for us, as these insects, they are pollinating the plants. The flowers, they are pollinated. The seeds are obtained. The fruits are obtained after pollination, and due to that, the agriculture production is higher. Means, as we can state, one estimate or one study states that for whatever these honeybees, they are producing or gaining the food, maybe of $1. Okay, so for that honey that costs $1, it is going to pollinate, or it is going to benefit you indirectly through pollination, nearly of worth of $20. So this type of research has also occurred. And pollination, you can know what the importance of pollination is. So conservation of these pollinators is very, very important. Third point is regarding utility of insects as food. Now, the insects, they are utilized as food in many of the countries, you can say in areas where there are locust swarms, in areas where there is somewhat shortage of food, or maybe also these insect carcasses or the bodies or the food derived out of the body of the insects that is rich in many of the vitamins, and those vitamins, they are utilized for curing some deficiency diseases in the children also. And this is international scenario wherein you can address the malnutrition very easily from this cheapest source, you may say, the insect, because these insects which are appearing, or which are, we may say, are pests or causing nuisance to us, we can convert that nuisance into some huge production that will reduce the burden on the other areas for food production. Now, here the insects, they are utilized as consumers, means they are consumers, so their utility is having a good response, or you may say good use in managing the environment also. Means you may say the ecosystem is having the balance when these insects are acting there. So what are the types of consumers? They may be entomophages. What is the meaning of entomophage? All those insects which are feeding on other insects. So they are biocontrol agents, you may say, for managing the pests. Then they are weed killers. So weed killers, they manage the nuisance or the problems caused by the weeds by eating them up. And third, scavengers. All these scavengers, they are doing the activity of degrading, or you may say breaking down the complex substances, complex wastes, into simpler forms for decomposition. So these are ultimately the cleaners, you may say, the scavengers. They act as cleaners in the atmosphere or in the ecosystem. The next, they are soil builders. You may see the mason flies as well as the termites. They utilize their skill as well as their social behavior for building up the soil, making some huge structures, and having their life cycle continuing through the structure itself. Many of the insects, they are utilized in forensic entomology. So the forensic sciences which are studied, you may say, what the crimes are, those crimes are detected through the utilization of these insects. Their life cycle is studied, and the four stages of their life, that is the egg stage, the larval or grub stage, and adult stage. The pupal stage also is the intermediate, which is inactive, and all these stages, they are providing you the basic understanding of how much the duration for that particular death or that carcass being left over. So the crimes can be, you may say, taken out, or its inquiry can be done through forensic entomology. Now, as bioindicator, what is the utility? So the places or some atmospheres, they are indicated by the insects. So in case one example is given at the right top corner, you may see a Chironomid larvae. This Chironomid is stating or saying that the water body in which it is present, means if you see the Chironomid larvae in greater number or their availability in that water, you can have the result or you can have the inference or conclusion derived that that water body is not up to the mark or it is in a poor state, means the oxygen level of that water, whether you may say the biological oxygen is very much deteriorated. Or second case, if that water body is in good state, you have good oxygen in that water, you may see the mayflies or stonefly larvae in that water body. Now, the aesthetic or philosophical or cultural use of insects, you may see the different insects which are so much so decorated by the mother nature, and on the lower side you can see one artifact or some necklace prepared out of the insect which is having beautiful coloration. There are camouflage, and such insects are used in aesthetics. Importance of beneficial insects in agriculture in case of their productivity. So the insects are productive. First, the honey and beeswax is obtained from the honeybees, and these honeybees, being social insects, they will gather the nectar, the pollen, they will prepare a colony and other products out of that. The byproducts of these honeybees is utilized as commercial products, and a big economy is also running through that. Along with that, the pollination service is also rendered, and it is generating income to the people who are hiring or who are lending their beehives or bee boxes for pollination purposes in orchards of the farmers. The next productive insect is the silkworm, and the product, the silk, is obtained from these silkworms. So that silk which is produced, it is natural silk obtained from insects. So this is animal origin fiber that we can see. There are many products made out of that silk. You may see the parachutes, you may see the saris, many other types of artifacts, many other types of fabrics prepared out of this silk. And along with that, the byproducts from these silkworms, they are utilized in feeding and also as a rich source of protein from the pupae of silkworms. Lac. Now, the lac insect, which is a homopteran, has the capacity or capability of releasing the resinous substance called as lac, and that lac is utilized in different places. In India, it is the sole product which is produced in the highest quantity as compared to the world. So lac is a very good product and revolutionary product, you may say, and it is having very big historical background. The productive insects next are the substances obtained from these insects, like the dyes and related substances. The cochineal dye is obtained from these insects which are present on the Opuntia, that is Dactylopius tomentosus, and some galls. They are either, you may say, medicinal also, they are used there. So some references, the names of some types: Aleppo galls, this gall, or these galls, they are produced by the plant as a response to the chemical substances which are released by the bite or the eating up of a cynipid wasp larvae. So such galls are produced and they are utilized in medicinal activities. Then the maysia, the Chinese or Turkey galls. So the dyes and related substances and galls are utilized for many other purposes or industrial purposes. Then in medicine, the utility of maggots is there. So the people who are suffering from diabetes and all, as references say, they are getting their wounds treated by the maggots. So this maggot therapy is a very good therapy, proven to be a boon. Then cantharidin is obtained from the blister beetles and the bee's venom. It is generally, or the forceful sting of honeybees, it is utilized for the treatment of different ailments. Now, these are the insects, bioagents that are helpful in managing the ecological balance, and that particular character of these insects, how they are managing, they are living on the other types of insects which are harmful. So these biocontrol agents, simply to say, are going to attack the harmful insects. They are going to kill them either quickly or within a span of time. And after killing them, our crop will be free of that particular pest. So this happens in crops also, and in general environment, general locality also. So the bioagents utilized as natural enemies are very, very useful insects, and classical biological control examples that we have, and that is a history, because many of the crops have been saved, and subsequently the humanity is also saved. So what are these bioagents? First, they are the parasites, then the parasitoids, and the predators. So the bioagents, like the parasitoids, you may say, first of all, what is a parasite and what is a parasitoid? Parasite is not capable of quickly eliminating the particular organism, but it stays in or on the body of that organism and derives its nutrition. But here, in case of parasitoid, that organism, that bioagent, will kill. Means after some stage or throughout the life cycle, one stage will be most vulnerable to the parasitoid. That parasitoid will attack the pest, and at some stage it is going to kill the insect, or rather pest, which is causing nuisance to us. So some stage, whatever I say, the larval stage of that particular parasitoid is going to live within the body or on the body of the pest. It will feed inside or on the body of the pest, and while it emerges, okay, first two or three stages will be attached in or outside the body of the pest, but the last stage, means mostly the adult stage, is going to be free living. So the parasitoid is free living at the adult stage, and the cycle continues. The adult is going to lay the eggs on the or inside the body of the stages of pest. So one example, Euplectra species, that is Euplectra parasitoid, and those white colored structures, they are the parasitoids, the Euplectras, which are emerging out of the body of the black colored fall armyworm. That fall armyworm is truly or certainly to be dead after the emergence or exit of these Euplectras species or parasitoids. This fall armyworm, Spodoptera frugiparda, is a very big menace in India now. The predators, you may say, the ladybird beetle. You can see the ladybird beetle feeding on the aphids, and that is a predator. What is a predator? Simply to say, the predator is out to attack its prey and devour the particular prey instantly. So as like the parasitoid, it is not attached with the life cycle of insects. It is 100% free living. The predator is 100% free living, and it is killing the prey instantly, and it is killing it for feeding. And as like the parasitoid, one parasitoid is going to have its attack or effect on a single host, but in case of these predators, they will attack multiple of prey, multiple numbers of prey, and they are going to manage them. So here the ladybird beetle is the predator of aphids. Now regarding the different institutes or various institutes related to beneficial insects, so what are they? The international institutes that we have, first to say, the Commonwealth Institute of Biocontrol in Trinidad, West Indies. Second, International Organization for Biocontrol of Noxious Animals and Plants, Zurich, Switzerland. And third, International Center for Agriculturally Important Insects, Bengaluru, India. The institutes, or you may say the national institutes, okay, the earlier were the international institutes, now the national institutes. The National Institute of Plant Health Management, it is NIPHM, located at Hyderabad. Second, National Bureau of Agricultural Insect Resources, that is NBAIR, located at Bengaluru. And the third, National Research Center for Integrated Pest Management, NCIPM, located at New Delhi. And fourth, the All India Coordinated Research Project on Biological Control of Crop Pests and Diseases is the National Institute dealing with the biocontrol agency. Then the institutes which are related with sericulture in India. So first of all, the Central Silk Board, Bengaluru. These are the national institutes, you may say. Then Central Sericulture Research and Training Institute, located at Behrampur, Orissa. Then third, Central Sericulture Research and Training Institute, located at Mysuru, Karnataka. Then fourth, Central Tassar Research and Training Institute, located at Ranchi in Jharkhand. And last, fifth one, Central Silk Technological Research Institute, Bengaluru, Karnataka. Now the institutes related with honeybee, they are studying there. So there is some typo mistake. It is not national, it is National Bee Board. The next is Central Bee Board, or the Central Bee Research and Training Institute, located at Pune. The institutes which are dealing with lac insects, they are Indian Institute of Natural Gums and Resins. So this was all regarding your first chapter of importance of beneficial insects in agriculture, and along with that the institutes, national and international. Thank you.